Hello students, I am Jnaneshwara TN, Assistant Professor of English. In the previous session, I had told you the characteristics of Milton's poetry. Today, we shall know Milton's contributions to English poetry. Milton was one of the greatest poets of England and can be placed next to Shakespeare. He was a great classicist and humanist. There was a blend of creative and intellectual power in him. Though he was an ardent Puritan, he was a passionate lover of art, beauty, and poetry. He did not share the Puritan hatred for drama and stage. Milton's contribution to English poetry. Milton's poetic creation is divided into three periods. The first period. This period covers his student life at university. He has composed poems of remarkable maturity and promise. The early poems of Milton are a sign of the greater works in his later life. During this period, he composed Ode on the Morning of Christ's Nativity, L'Allegro, Il Penseroso, and Comus. Ode on the Morning of Christ's Nativity. This poem was composed while Milton was a student at the university. It is an ode in dignified lyric. It was written under the influence of metaphysical poets. The poem indicates the influence of Spenser also. It illustrates the great poetic talent of Milton. It is considered as the most beautiful ode in English poetry. L'Allegro. It is a long and descriptive poem. It presents the life of the joyful man from the early morning to the time of his retiring. The poem is a prayer to Goddess Mirth to allow the poet to live with her amid the delights of rustic scenes. It depicts the cavalier view of life. Il Penseroso. This poem represents the thoughtful man. It is addressed to the goddess Melancholy, asking her to bring peace and quiet, leisure and contemplation. Milton describes the pleasures of studious meditative life, of tragedy, epic poetry, and music. It represents the Puritan outlook of life. Comus. It is in masque form. Masque is a kind of drama. The plot of Comus is simple. The story is taken from mythology. It is a remarkable poem which shows the great poetical qualities. It represents the triumph of virtue. The poem reflects the influence of Puritanism on Milton. Lycidas. It is a pastoral elegy upon the death of King Edward, a college mate of Milton who was drowned in the sea. The real theme of the poem is the uncertainty and torment caused by death. The poem of mourning becomes poem of vigorous satire with the note of personal feelings and speculations. The second period. It was a period of political works and prose writings. He composed 18 sonnets of varied interest. His sonnets are known for sincerity of feeling, clarity of thought, simplicity of expression, and lack of humor. On his blindness is the remarkable sonnet. The third period. It is the most fruitful and significant period in the life of Milton. It is during this period he produced three monumental works, namely Paradise Lost, Paradise Regained, and Samson Agonists. Paradise Lost. It is a classical epic in 12 books. The opening lines of the epic outline its scope. It deals with the theme of man's disobedience to God and loss of paradise. The scene of action is universal space. The characters are God and his creatures, Adam and Eve, Satan as fallen angel. The plucking of fruit of knowledge is the main event. The war between the God and Satan has been dramatized with grandeur. Paradise Lost as an epic is remarkable for its loftiness of its theme and style. It is embellished with epic similes, metaphors, and images in a grand scale. It is appreciated as the greatest epic ever composed in English literature. It is an immortal work of a great genius. Paradise Regained. It is a sequel to Paradise Lost. It answers the questions raised in Paradise Lost. It opens with the journey of Christ into wilderness. Satan employs the tricks of temptation. There is a dialogue between Christ and Satan. In the process, Christ emerges victorious. Unlike in Paradise Lost, Satan has been presented as cunning old man gathering tricks. There is no action and characters are uninteresting, so it is inferior to Paradise Lost. Samson Agonists. It is in dramatic form of biblical theme. It is modeled on classical tragedy. The hero of the play, Samson, represents Hebrew spirit. The spirit of religion and puritanism prevails in the play. The play brings out autobiographical elements. Dear students, let us recall what we have learnt in this session. Milton's poetic creation is divided into three periods. During the first period, he composed Ode on the Morning of Christ's Nativity, L'Allegro, Il Penseroso, and Comus. L'Allegro presents the life of the joyful man. Il Penseroso represents the thoughtful man. Comus is in masque form and is taken from mythology. Lycidas is a pastoral elegy upon the death of King Edward. The second period was a period of political works and prose writings. During the third period, he produced three monumental works, namely Paradise Lost, Paradise Regained, and Samson Agonists. Paradise Lost is a classical epic in 12 books. It is appreciated as the greatest epic ever composed in English literature. Paradise Regained is a sequel to Paradise Lost. It answers the questions raised in Paradise Lost. Samson Agonists is in dramatic form of biblical theme. It is modeled on classical tragedy. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.